Something will happen today. Something extraordinary. Something powerful. Something miraculous. Raise up that hand. Father, in the name of Jesus,
Baba, ni oruko Jesu,
you have never failed. You cannot fail. You will not fail. Today we come to you with great expectation. Today we come to you with faith in Christ,
with
faith that works wonders. And we ask you tonight, your wonders will come upon every life in Jesus' name. Mountains will roll away. Problems will roll away. All those yokes will be broken. And every curse will be taken away. We know that you are going to do it. Put a smile on every face. Joy in every heart.
Confirm
the miracle in everyone. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Thank you very much. God bless you. Wonderful to see your face again. Are you alright over there? Are you expecting something over there? You know, I'm going to go back to the very beginning of creation. I want to go and see the miracle that happened on that first day. When God, the Almighty, decided He was going to make the earth. He was going to create everything. And then He decided He will create man. What kind of man did He create? What happened to that man that He created? And what happens today when the hand of God comes upon your life and remolds you and recreates you and remakes you? Look at Genesis chapter 1. And I'm reading from verse 26. And God said, let us make man in our image. Let us make man in our image. Now all the animals have been made already. And God didn't say, let us make man in the image of one of these animals. Lucifer was already there.
Lucifer
he had turned to become Satan. God did not say, let us make man in the image of Lucifer. The angels already created. Angels, wonderful angels. God did not say, let us make man in the image of an angel. He said, let us make man in our image. After our likeness. And let them have dominion over the fish of the sea. And over the fowl of the air. And over the cattle. And over the earth. And over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. Genesis chapter 1 verse 27. So God created man in His own image. In the image of God created He him. Male and female created He them. He created man in His own image. He created the woman in His own image. And God bless them. Tonight you are blessed. Somebody there said, tonight you are blessed. And God bless them, and God said unto them, be fruitful. Multiply. Replenish the earth. Subdue it.
And
have dominion over the fish of the sea. And over the fowl of the air. And over every living thing that moved upon the earth. That's the story of the creation of man. I'm talking to you tonight on the miracle of a new creation.
Lala imo mba esoro lori ise iyanu edatito.
The miracle of a new creation.
Ise iyanu ti edatito enita
atunda. I read the passage already to you.
Mo ti ka awon eriti oro Olorun na fun.
God's original creation was beautiful and wonderful. Man's nature was like the nature of God. Man was number one, holy. Number two, man was happy. Number three, man was healthy. There was no sickness. There was no infirmity. There was no sin. There was no suffering. There was no sorrow. There was no oppression. Because God said, we're making man. The Father, the Son, the Holy Ghost. Let us make man. In our image. After our likeness.
And
as God the Almighty had authority and dominion. Man had dominion and authority. That creation. Described and demonstrated for us. The word holiness. H. Healthy.
Healthy,
no sickness at all, no infirmity at all. Orderliness. Everything was in order. Man at the top. The animals under them. The creation under them. The rivers under them. And animals did not jump up to hurt the man. The vegetation did not resist the cultivation of man. When God created the universe, there was health. There was orderliness. There was love. Adam and Eve did not fight.
Adam and Eve
did not fight. It's like there was understanding between the man and the animals. Adam just stood there and said, this one is a lion, that one is a goat, that one is a sheep, that one is animal. There was no resistance. Everything just worked amicably, affectionately. Everything, just speak and eat. You cannot do that today. If you are hungry now,
baby,
you have to run back home and look for something to eat. You know, there's a lot of plant over here. You cannot just go there now and eat something. At that time, there was no poison. Incorruptibility in the creation of God. Because he said, we're going to make another heaven at the station of the earth. Everything was noble. There was nothing degrading. There was nothing oppressive. Everything completely noble. Everything was excellent. Let us make man in our image. After our likeness. Let them have dominion. over the fish of the sea, over everything that creepeth upon the earth. And so God created man in his own image, after his likeness. There was selflessness. There was nobody that was selfish. Everybody, you go your way, I go my way. Because that was the creation of God. There was satisfaction. You know, God gave everything. What else are we going to look for? Everything was under the authority and dominion of man. Satisfaction. That's the original creation of God. But then a strange thing happened. A stranger came from the outside. His name is Satan. He tempted our first parents. They sinned. They fell. When they fell, the creation turned around. When they sinned, things changed. You see today, something has been going normal, becomes abnormal. A function has been going straight forward, it becomes crooked. If something has been going up, it goes down. If you have been building something, once sin comes in, it collapses. That original creation that God had made, and when he made everything, he looked at everything and said everything was good, everything was very good. When the stranger came in, honor turned to humiliation. The honor that man had, everything collapsed. It turned to humiliation. Obedience turned to obstinacy. Instead of man obeying God, animals obeying man, instead of vegetation responding to the labor of our hand, cruelty came in, obstinacy came in, obedience turned to obstinacy,
love
turned to lust. Instead of having normal love, Christ-like love, divine love, God's love, it was not fleshly lust. Because things turned around when the stranger came in, when Satan came in. Innocence turned to iniquity. Because now Satan had come in. When you allow Satan to come to your life, when you allow evil spirit to come to your life, something that
has
been flowing normal and flowing well, everything turns upside down. Nobility turned to nothingness. Adam could not control Cain.
Adam kole sakoso
Cain. Cain just took something and killed his brother.
Senikaini kan mu nkan ka to si pa arakunrin re.
And then God said, Cain, where is Abel thy brother? And the man was even naughty to God. What are you asking me? Am I my brother's keeper? Nobility turned to naughtiness. And then exaltation turned to excuses. The man got promoted and set up on high. They began to make excuses.
Oh, Adalawa, we.
I don't know why that happened. It's a woman you gave me.
Woman,
why have you done this? Oh, it's not my fault. It's a serpent that beguiled me. The exaltation of man, everything turned to excuses. And selflessness turned to selfishness. And scarcity replaced sufficiency. Now man is suffering. And this is not the original creation. The miracle is going to happen to you. Somebody, am I talking to somebody there tonight? A miracle is coming your way. A miracle of a new creation. This was the situation of man. That's why Jesus Christ had to come. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in me will not perish but have everlasting life. With the stranger that came in, with Satan that came in, with sin that came in, and everything tumbled, everything was spoiled. That's why Jesus Christ has now come. And he wants to reorganize everything in your life. Somebody there, you'll be reorganized today. He will
touch
your life today. He will touch your life today. That's why Christ has now come. And as Christ has come, he wants to do something. If you will allow him tonight, he will do something. I said, if you will allow him tonight, he will do something in your life in Jesus' name.
I'm
looking at Hebrews chapter 12 verse 10. But if verily for a few days just indoors after their own pleasure. But he for our profit, that we might be partakers of his holiness.
Nitori won to wa fun ojo die bi o ba ti dara loju won sugbon on fun ere wa ki awa ki o le je alabapin iwa mimo re.
Almighty God, look at the condition of man.
Olorun Olodumare o wo ko ti eniyan wa.
And he saw that the original place he put us,
o ti wa ri pe ipo akoko to n fi wa si,
the place of honor,
ipo ola,
the place of exaltation,
ipo igbega,
the place of dominion,
ipo ijegaba,
the place of power,
ipo agbara,
and the place of happiness,
ipo ajo ayo,
and the place of holiness,
ipo iwa mimo,
and the place of health,
ipo ilera,
where he put us, we fail.
Asubu,
he said, Jesus,
only Jesus,
go and lift them up.
Lo, lati lo gbe won soke.
Go and raise them up.
Lo, ko lo gbe won soke.
Tonight he will lift you up.
Lale yo gbe e soke.
Tonight he will raise you up.
Lale yo fa o soke.
How does he do that?
Bawo ni o tin se eleyi.
I'm going to divide the message to three parts.
Mo pin wa suna si pa meta.
Number one,
ikini,
the perception of his notable honor.
Ona ni ni ini ni ni ola re.
The perception of his notable honor. You need to understand the kind of honor the Lord wants to bring you to. What it was originally, where he created us originally, the dominion and the authority he gave us originally, the perception, the understanding of that notable honor. Number 2, our preparation for his noticeable healing.
Oni imura silewa fun imularada re eto e pe a le sakiyesi.
The healing he gives you tonight, your neighbors will see you and say something happened to you.
ìwòsàn tí ó fún ẹ lálẹ́ yìí àwọn ará àdúgbò rẹ wọ́n sọ pé nǹkan kan ṣẹlẹ̀ sí
ẹ. The deliverance he gives you tonight, your neighbors will look at you and say, don't even tell me, I know about it already.
Nígbà tó bá dá àdúgbò yín àwọn ará àdúgbò sọ pé mo ti ẹ̀ tí ì sọ fún mo lè rí inú ayé ẹ.
A kind of healing that is noticeable.
Irú ìwòsàn èyí tí a lè ṣàkíyèsí.
A kind of deliverance that is noticeable.
Irú ìdáǹde táwọn ènìyàn lè rí.
A kind of recreation that people can tell and people can see in your life.
Irú ìṣẹ̀dá àtúndá tí Ọlọ́run ó ṣe táwọn ènìyàn lè dámọ̀ tán lè rí inú ayé.
The preparation you will make.
Ìmúrasílẹ̀ tó ṣe.
The response you will give to the Lord.
Down to fi fun Oluwa.
So that what he wants to do.
Ki on to fe se.
Tonight is your night.
Ale ilale re.
Where are you? I said tonight is your night.
Nibo lo wa mo lale ilale re.
That pain he'll strike it off.
Gbogbo iroro yen yo gbon won
danu. That infirmity he will strike it off.
Gbogbo ailera yen yo gbon won danu.
Those blind eyes will become brightened tonight.
Gbogbo oju ti oriran yen kedere ni o mole.
I will see.
I
said I will see. And out of that wheelchair, the mighty power of God will come upon your life. You'll come out in Jesus' name.
Lori aga iyaro to joko le lori agbara Olorun yo tubulu e o si
de a preparation from your side.
Imurasile kan gbodo todo re wa.
Our preparation for his noticeable healing.
Imurasile wa fun iwosan re ti a le sakiyesi.
Number 3, your portion in his new holiness.
Eketa ona ni ipin ti wa ninu iwa mimo re titun.
You have a portion in what God has provided through Christ.
Ipin ti ti e ninu nti Oluwa ti pese nipasẹ Christ.
I was waiting for you. Amen.
Mo reti
portion you will not miss it in Jesus name.
Ohun to je ipin ti e o ni padanu e loruko Jesu.
Let's come back to number 1.
E je ka para sinu koko kini.
The perception of his notable honor.
Nini ola re eti awon eniyan le re ta le sakiyesi.
Come back to Genesis chapter 1.
E je ka para sinu Genesis ori kini.
I'm reading here from verse 26.
How can I say kerin din ni ogbon.
Genesis chapter 1 verse 26.
Genesis ori kini ese kerin din ni ogbon.
And God said, let us make man in our image.
Olorun si pe je ki a da eniyan le aworan wa.
After our likeness.
Gege bi ri wa.
And let them have dominion over the fish of the sea.
Ki won ki o si joba lori e
and over the fowl of the air.
Ati lori eye oju oro.
And over the cattle.
Ati lori eranko.
And over all the earth.
Ati lori gbogbo ile.
And over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth.
Ati lori ohun gbogbo tin rako lori ile.
So God created man.
Be li Olorun da eniyan.
And then he tells us in his own image.
Oni li aworan re.
In the image of God created he him.
Li aworan Olorun li o da.
Male and female created he them.
Ati akọ ati abo li o da won.
And God bless them.
Olorun si sure fun won.
Somebody is blessed today and God bless them.
Olorun sure fun Olorun sure fun
won. Somebody there, you are blessed tonight and God bless them.
Oluwa bukun fun won. Oluwa bukun fun won na.
Curse will vanish away from your life.
Gbogbo egun yo poora ninu aye re.
Every plant the heavenly Father has not planted.
Gbogbo ohun ti Olorun wa ko gbin sinu aye re.
Tonight will be uprooted from your life in Jesus name.
Lale yo di fifa tu kuro ninu aye e loruko Jesu.
The perception of his notable honor.
Nini tabi jijogun awon ola re e tawon eniyan yo sakiyesi.
How do you understand?
Bawo lo se le loye re.
I'm telling you something here.
Mo so nkan kan fun e bayi.
If you know what God thinks about you.
To ba le ronu kan to Olorun ro nipa re.
If you know what God desires for you.
To ba le Tolorun fe fun o.
You will not fall for anything lower.
Oh, ni subu tabi ko teriba fun
kan. You will not accept and say, okay, if this is all I have, then that's all right. You'll say no.
Oh, ni fe gba pe awon gba je se mi pe eleyi kekere na ti to.
Before this life ends.
Si aye re ko to dopin.
Everything God ordained for you.
Ohun gbogbo Tolorun ti yan fun o.
Everything God has earmarked for you.
Ohun gbogbo Tolorun ti ko sile fun o.
And he says, in this new creation.
E to so pe ninu eda titun yi o.
This is what I have for you.
Ohun ti mo ni fun eleyi.
You are going to possess it.
O jogun re o ni won.
Nothing will stop you.
If
you don't stop yourself, if you have the right perception, and you make the proper preparation, and you recognize your portion, I'm telling you, from tonight, your life will be totally different. In the creation that God has made, what do you see? Number one, honor through God.
Oni ola nipasẹ Olorun.
Honor through God.
Ola lati odo Olorun.
His honor will not come to your life anymore.
Aiwa lola ko ni wa soju
ona re. His grace will not come to your life anymore.
Awon abuku tabi egan ko ni wa sona re.
Degradation will not come to your life anymore.
Idibaje ko wa ni wa sinu aye re.
Number one, honor.
Ikini oni ola.
I'm looking at Psalm 8.
Mo n wo orin Dafidi orin kejo.
Psalm 8 verse 3.
Orin Dafidi orin kejo ese
keta. When I consider the heavens,
the
work of thy fingers, the moon and the stars,
which
thou hast ordained,
what is
man that thou art mindful of him, or the son of man that thou visitest him? Thou hast made him a little lower than the angels. Only a little lower than the angels. And has crowned him with glory and honor. And remember, this is not Genesis, this Psalm. This one, thousands of years after creation. And David was saying, I look at man at my own time.
David was
in the might of God. In the plan of God. Glory and honor. Tonight you are coming to that honor. You're coming to the creation of God. You're coming to his desire and his purpose and plan for you. And in verse 6, thou hast made him to have dominion over the works of thy hand. Thou hast put all things under his feet. Under his feet. I'm going to make it personal. Under my feet. Under my feet. Evil powers under my feet. Sickness under my feet. Cancer under my feet. Ulcer under my feet. Premature death under my feet. Calamity under my feet. He has given us honor. That's why Christ came. The Christ didn't come so I can just go to church. I can go to church without Christ coming. The people were going to their synagogues without Christ coming. They were going to their temples without Christ coming. Christ came. So he can take you out of that place of dishonor. And bring you to the platform of honor. And bring all the things that were crawling upon you before, all the things destroying your life before, he'll put them under your feet from today. Did you hear what he said? Behold, I give unto you power over all the power of the enemy.
And
he said, you will tread on serpents and scorpions. And then he says, nothing shall by any means hurt you. Apart from heaven, so that the original creation will be reproduced in your life tonight. Honor through God. Obedience to God. When, you know, as Christ came, and then he comes into our hearts, he puts a magnet in our hearts. You are magnetized to the side of the Lord. There is a desire to obey God. There is a pleasure in obeying God. God. When God created Adam and Eve, that was what was in their heart. They just love God. And they love the commandments of the Lord. Number one, honor to God. Number two, obedience to God. Number three, likeness to God. Let us create man in our image, in our likeness. That he is the creature resembled the creator. The son resembled the father. The offspring resembled the parents. Likeness unto God. And that's why it says that as he is, so are we in this present world. The next one is the image of God. The great man. After our likeness. After our image. So that the very heart of God. The very mind of God. The very nature of God. That's what Adam and Eve are. That's what they lost. And that's why Jesus Christ has come. He wants to restore us back to what we lost in Adam. Honor through God. Obedience to God. Likeness to God. The image of God. Nature of God. The nature of God. Is the nature of dominion. The nature of power. The nature of righteousness. The nature of truth. The nature of truthfulness. The nature of holiness. Because that's how God created man. The perception we have. Some people do not understand why Jesus came. He looked at every couch. He looked at every step. And he looked at every item. That man should resemble God. And we lost everything. And Jesus Christ has now come. So that he will restore you to that nature of God. He exploits like God. Exploits like God. Look at Adam. Can you think of one man and one woman controlling that whole garden? Controlling all the earth. And he told Adam and Eve,
he said,
subdue the earth. Not just the garden. That man could go anywhere. Before he fell, his word was with authority. Before he fell, lions were not a threat to him. Before he fell, crocodiles were not a threat to him. Before he fell, he had exploits like God. And that's what the Lord is bringing us to. The people that do know their God. And the people that do know Christ. And Christ pulls you out of your disgrace and degradation. He pulls you out. Power will come into you. You'll not be afraid of little malaria. You'll not be afraid of cockroach spirit. You will not be afraid of reptiles. The earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. This is my Father's territory. And anywhere you are, authority and dominion. You go to the village, authority and dominion. Anywhere you go, and you're not hiding yourself somewhere. There are some bad people there, they want to kill me. No.
Rara o.
Nobody will kill you. After tonight. I said after tonight. In the day and in the night. You will do exploits in Jesus' name. And then supernatural through God. The supernatural through God. In the original creation. Man was the representative of heaven on earth. It was the sub-headquarters of God here on earth. And man was to be the administrator of God here on earth. The plan of heaven was to be carried out on earth by the man. And the power of heaven was given to him to carry that out. Supernatural from God. The supremacy in God. The supremacy that he had in God. That's what Adam and Eve had at the beginning. And then there was a fall. And man now became helpless, hopeless, sick, suffering, sorrowful, until Christ came. And Christ is asking you tonight, do you want to come back to where you were before? Yaba is not answering me.
Ara Yaba Odawo.
I said, do you want to come back to what we had before?
Njofe pada sipo tati watele ribere pepe.
We're coming back.
An pada si
be. I said we're coming back.
Moni aok pada si be.
Courage is coming to your heart.
Igbo ya onwo enu okan re
lo. Life is coming into you.
Iye onwo enu re lo.
Authority is coming to you.
Ase onwo enu re lo.
You will not continue in weakness.
Oh ni tesiwaju ninu
ore yen. You will not continue in discouragement.
Oh ni tesiwaju ninu idaya foye.
You will not continue in fear.
Oh ni tesiwaju ninu ibe
oye. You will not continue in poverty.
Oh ni tesiwaju ninu osi.
Christ has come.
Christ today.
Christ died for you on the cross of
Calvary.
Looking unto Christ. The
author
and finisher of your faith.
Who
for the joy that was set before him. He despised the shame. He endured the cross. So that he'll take you out of that place you are. He'll take you up. You're coming up tonight. Our preparation for his noticeable health.
He's
going to heal you. Somebody there said he's going to heal you. Get ready, it's coming. Miracle of healing. Miracle of salvation. Miracle of deliverance. It's coming your way in Jesus' name. Our preparation. What preparation do you make? And if you will prepare tonight, I can assure you a miracle is coming your way. What preparation do you make? Humble yourself before the Lord. Humble yourself before the Lord.
He
said in 2 Chronicles chapter 7 verse 14.
If
my people which are called by my name shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven. I will forgive their sin. I will heal their land. Humble yourselves before the Lord. Open the door of your heart to the Lord. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door and he says, Jesus, I want you. Jesus, I desire you. Jesus, I believe you died for me on the cross of Calvary. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come in unto him. I will sup with him. I will fellowship with him. You come to the Lord. You say, today I open the door of my heart. Come in today. Come in to stay. Come in and forgive me. Come in and cleanse me. Come in and take my sins away. Humble yourself before the Lord. Open the door of your heart to the Lord. Leave the old life and cleave to the new life. For this
causal
a man leave father and mother and cleave unto his wife. He wants to be your bridegroom. He wants to be your husband. He wants to be your healer. He wants to be your Lord and master. You leave the old master and you cleave unto the Lord. You leave sin and you cleave to the Savior. You leave darkness and cleave to the light. You leave evil and cleave to his grace. Incline your ears unto the Lord. I come to point number 3. I'm talking to somebody now. I said I'm talking to somebody now.
Where
are you there? Are you hearing? Are you going to answer the Lord? When he calls me, I will answer. He wants to lift me up. He wants to forgive me. He wants to set me free. When he calls me, I will answer. Who will answer over there? I said, who will answer over there? Lord, call your people. Call them out of that prison. Bring them to the palace. Call them out of that dungeon. Bring them to dominion. I know you will answer. Something good will happen to you. Your portion in the new, in its new holiness.
And
look at this. Isaiah chapter 43. Isaiah chapter 43. I'm reading from verse 18. He did the old creation. He made the old creation. But Adam and Eve fell. And we fell in them and with them. But now he says, I'm going to do it all over again. He will do it all over again in your life. See what he wants to do. Isaiah 43. Verse 18. Remember ye not the former things, neither consider the things of old. Behold, I will do a new thing. Somebody there. I said somebody there. Almighty God says this night. I will do a new thing. And then it says, now it shall spring forth. When is your miracle? When is your healing? When is your salvation? When is your lifting up? It says, now it shall spring up. Shall ye not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. The Lord has said, your time has come. What will he do? What has he promised to do? So as to bring us to what Adam and Eve lost. Number 1, a new heart. A new heart. The heart is the center of your life. The heart is the source of your thinking. The heart is the fountain of your strength. The heart is the starting point of your progress. If the heart is weak, your life will be weak. If your life, if your heart is downtrodden and trampled upon, your life is downtrodden and trampled upon. If your heart is timid and weak, your life will be timid and weak. If your heart is sinful, your life will be sorrowful and your life will be sinful. And he says, come to me today, I'll give you a new heart. Somebody there. A new heart is coming. I said a new heart is coming. A new life. A new instrument. A new instrument. Where are you there? Are you still there? Look up. I said look up. If it rains, the rain will not cancel your miracle. You will not go and hide somewhere. Because God is about to distribute miracles. Your portion is coming. Your portion is coming. Where are you there? It will get to you. You will get to it. From the time of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of God suffered violence. And the violent take it by force. Nothing will hinder you tonight. A new heart. Give me a good amen. A new obedience. Another amen. A new life. Another amen. What's the next thing there? Tell me. A new instrument. Look at your portion here. Say, I'm looking at my portion now. I can't hear you. Isaiah chapter 41. I'm looking at verse 15. Behold, I will make thee a new sharp threshing instrument having teeth. I'm going to read that again so that I can hear whether you are the one I'm talking to or not. He says, behold, I will make thee a new sharp threshing instrument having teeth. And thou shalt thresh the mountains and beat them small, and shall make the hills a chaff. Thou shalt fan them, and the wind will carry them away. And the wind will scatter them. And thou shalt rejoice in the Lord. And shalt glory in the Holy One of Israel. A new instrument. Where is he? Where is she there? All those mountains will vanish away. A new name. A new name. The Lord is going to give you a new name. You are not a defeated man anymore. You are a person in dominion from now on. A new name. Behold, I give my name unto you. Whatsoever you shall ask or bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatsoever you shall loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. A new example. A new example. Because Christ has died for us, leaving us an example that we should walk after his steps. What does that mean? The way he dealt with sin, he gave you an example. Deal with sin that way. The way he dealt with Satan, he gave you an example. Deal with Satan that way. When Satan comes and he wants to bind you up and oppress your life.
Nigba ti Satan ba wa lati de o ni igbekun ko si ma rin o mole.
Satan, leave me alone. Leave me alone. What have I done? It's only me you are coming to, and you don't allow me. Stop that and deal with that Satan and say, Satan, get thee behind me. He'll get away from you.
O wa nso pe Satan fi mi lorun le, fi mi lorun le, emi nikan lo ma ma wa lu lati wa yo lenu, fi mi lorun le. Rara o, wa so pe Satan kuro nibe, wa pase fun Jesu, wa si sa kuro lodo re.
The way he dealt with sickness.
Ona to gba doju ko aisan.
And said, be thou healed.
Oni ki o gba
iwosan. He has given you an example, a new example.
O ti fun eni apere rere
awo ko se rere. And you come in authority.
O wa wa ninu ase
re. I have the name of the Lord.
Mo ni oruko Oluwa.
I have the promise of the Lord.
Mo ni ileri Oluwa.
This sign shall follow them that believe.
And when you o ma ba on to gba
lodo. In my name they shall cast out devils.
Ni oruko mi won ma le awon
in my name they will lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. And tonight you will recover in Jesus' name. The word is in your mouth. The name is in your mouth. The spirit is in your heart. The authority is in your spirit. And the anointing that breaks the yoke is given to you. He has given us an example, a new example. Deal with sin like he dealt with sin. Deal with Satan like he dealt with Satan. Deal with sickness like he dealt with sickness. And deal with evil spirits like he dealt with evil spirits. I have the victory. I have the victory. As a new spirit. A new spirit. The spirit of a conqueror. The spirit of courage. The spirit of power. The spirit of authority. The spirit of fearlessness. That anywhere you go, from today you will be in authority. All power, all authority is given unto me in heaven and on earth. Go ye therefore. You have that new spirit. It says in Ezekiel chapter 11. And in verse 19. A new spirit will I put within you. A new source of supply. A new source of supply. Philippians chapter 4 verse 19. My God shall supply. My God shall supply. My God shall supply. All your needs. According to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. A new source of supply. Everything is available for you. I said everything is available for you. He will heal you. He will forgive you. He will set you free. He will save your soul. He will turn your life around. He will do something good in your life. But you need to prepare. Lord, I come. I humble myself. Lord, I come. I open the door of my heart. Lord, I come. I leave the past. I cleave unto the Lord. Lord, I come. I incline my heart to the Lord. Lord, I come. I nail all my sins to the cross of Calvary. Lord, I come. I escape from perdition and destruction. Lord, I come. I seek the Lord while he may be found. Lord, I come. I surrender all to Christ. Once you do that, that new thing will begin in your life tonight. It's bowed and eyes closed. Eyes closed. The Lord is coming your way right now. The time of forgiveness has come. The time of lifting up has come. And the time of salvation has come. And is going to do something new. Something you never knew before. A new miracle is coming upon your life.
Let's
bow
down
and eyes closed. If you are telling the Lord, oh Lord, do it for me tonight. Oh Lord, do it for me tonight. You raise up your hand. Indicate to the Lord. Lord, I am here. Lord, I am here. I want it now. If you are raising up your hand, you will stand up.
Why did they do?
Stand up for Jesus. You are raising up your hand. And you're saying,
Jesus,
you and I today will be connected. I leave the past, I come to my Savior. I leave my sin, I come to Christ. I leave darkness, I come to the light. You raise up your hand, you stand up. If you're standing up and you mean it, Take whatever you have, hold everything in your hand, and come right to the front here. Come over here, come. The Lord is calling you. The Lord is calling you. Come unto me. Come unto me. All you that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Rest in your soul. Rest in your spirit. A new life is coming. You're going to leave the past. All the sins of the past, you are going to leave them. All the gangs of the past, you are going to leave them. All the lying of the past, you are going to leave everything. All the evil of the past, you are going to leave. All the wickedness of the past, you are going to leave. And you come and cleave to the Master, to the Savior, to the Lord. Keep on coming, it's calling you. You humble yourself before the Lord. As you come. He says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves. So while you are there, just close your eyes and say, Lord, I will not be proud anymore. I know I'm a sinner. Talk to the Lord. Let him hear the voice of humility. Keep on coming, keep on coming. The Lord is calling you. And the Lord is saying, tonight can be the night of upliftment. Tonight will be the night of holiness. Holding you up. Everything we lost in the first Adam, we want to regain in Christ. And tonight is the beginning. Keep on coming, keep on coming. Older person can come. Elderly person can come. Aged person can come. And the young people can come. Lord, I come. Open the door of your heart. And say, Lord, here I am. Come in to stay. Come in and take my sins away. Leave the past. And cleave to the Savior. Incline your ear to the word of the Lord. And do what he has told you to do. And bundle all your sins together, nail them to the cross of Calvary. Tell the Lord, he will answer your prayer. He'll save your soul. He'll take your sins away. He'll change your life. A new thing will come to you. It's going to happen now. I said it's going to happen now. I said it's going to happen now. Raise up that hand.
Now one yes, okay.
Raise it up very well.
Now it's okay, Dada.
You're going to pray after me. When we finish, you'll pray with my minister working with me here. You say it aloud and say from the depth of your heart, Almighty God, I thank you today. Today is a new day. Lord, I come. I humble myself before you. I know I am a sinner. You are my Savior. Lord, I call upon you. Forgive my sin. I open up my heart. Come in. Set me free. Come in. Save my soul. I leave the past. I cleave to the Lord. I will stay with the Lord. Lord, I pray, all your word I have heard, I incline my heart to that word. I nail my sins to the cross of Calvary. Take them away. Tonight. Tonight. I escape from destruction. Tonight. I have come to seek your face. Tonight. I surrender my heart. I surrender my life. I surrender my will unto the Almighty God. Receive me, Lord. Take me, Lord. Save me, Lord. Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. My sins are forgiven. I am saved. I am saved. I am saved. In Jesus' name I pray.
Awa elede Yoruba egba tele n bayi Olorun e je ka soro soke Olorun mo dupe lowo yin fun ojo oni mo dupe lowo yin fun oro yin mo ti gbo oro yin mo si ri ara mi gege bi elese mo nje wo awon ese mi fun yin gbogbo awon igbe aye ateyin wa gbogbo ese ateyin wa gbogbo awon iwa buburu mi atijo mo nje wo won fun yin mo si npin ninu okan mi lati ko gbogbo ese mi sile mo ngba Jesu Oluwa gege bi Oluwa ati olugbala mi mo si ti pinu pe lati oni lo ngo ma te yin leyin ngo ma se ife yin ngo gbegbe aye mi fun yin Jesu Oluwa mo sile kun okan mi sile e wa wo inu okan mi e wa yi aye mi pada e wa so aye mi dotun agbara atore ofe ti ma fi gbegbe aye to wu yin lati oni lo e je ko wo inu okan mi mo dupe tori pe e ti se mo dupe tori pe a ti gba mi la mo dupe tori pe e ti dariji mi ni oruko Jesu ni mo gbadura.
I'm going to pray for you now.
Raise
up your two hands in surrender. Father, in the name of Jesus, you have called your people and they have come. You will not fail. According to your promise, forgive them in Jesus' name. Save them in Jesus' name. Let your spirit bear witness in their hearts that their sins have been forgiven. Write their names in the book of life in heaven. Lift them up. Change their lives. They'll never be the same again. Thank you because I know you have answered. In Jesus' name I pray.
Ni oruko Jesu ni mo gbadura.
Praise the Lord. The Lord has saved you. Praise the Lord.
Eke hallelujah.
That miracle is coming.
He said yanu na nbo.
A new creation.
E dati ton.
A new power.
Agbara titun.
A new healing.
Iwosan otun.
A new deliverance.
Idande titun.
Is coming upon your life right now.
O nbo wa sori aye re bayi.
You know when God created.
Nigba ti Olorun ba seda nkan.
He just said, let there be.
Ani je ki o wa.
Let there be light and there was light.
E je ki imale ki o wa, imale si wa.
Let there be ocean, there was ocean.
Ani je ki okun ko wa, yo si wa.
Let all the waters gather to one place and it was so.
Ani e je gbogbo mi ko wojo ko sibi kan a si ri be.
And now his hand is going to do a creative work in your life.
Lale yo wo re yo si se iseda ninu aye re.
Once he says sickness go away, it's gone.
Blind
eyes be opened and begin to see. It happens immediately.
Layman,
rise up and walk. It happens.
And
when you hear the final amen, You check up yourself. The miracle is there already. If you need healing, you raise up your hand. You need deliverance, you raise up your hand. Whatever challenge it is, you want the Lord to take away, just raise up your hand over there. And lay the other hand upon yourself. And then when you hear the final amen, that means the miracle is confirmed already. Almighty God will come to you with faith.
Will
come in the new anointing that breaks every yoke.
Will
come standing on the promises that cannot fail.
Will
come in the confidence of the manifestation of your power.
And
come upon every person here. On behalf of every sick person, every oppressed person, every afflicted person there, and Lord, I pray, touch and heal them in Jesus' name. I command that sickness in your body, come out in Jesus' name. I command that affliction and oppression of the enemy of the devil, come out in Jesus' name. That yoke is broken from your life. You're free. You are set free. Receive your freedom in Jesus' name. That madness, that insanity, that evil spirit, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. All the disturbance in your system, in your head, in your mind, because of marijuana and because of all those things you have been eating and drinking and smoking before, I cancel them. You are free in Jesus' name. The person that is having swelling in the body, in the neck, in the head, in the armpit, in the leg, I command the swelling, come out in Jesus' name. That cancer, I command you, dry up, be healed in Jesus' name.
Ulcer,
be healed in Jesus' name. The pain of arthritis and stiffness in your joints, be healed in Jesus' name. Issue of blood there, dry up in Jesus' name.
Pan,
be healed in Jesus' name. Coughing out blood, be healed in Jesus' name. And anywhere the fire of the devil is burning in your head, anywhere, I command that fire to stop right now in Jesus' name.
Sickles,
cell, anemia, be healed in Jesus' name. Those blind eyes and dim eyes, I command right now, be healed in Jesus' name. That person having stroke or paralysis, let the power of Christ come there right now. That power that raises up the lame, I send that power in your joint, in your waist, in your muscle, in your nerves. Rise up and walk in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for every kind of miracle, every kind of deliverance, every kind of healing, every kind of signs and wonders, everywhere to the right, to the left, to the center, to the back. Receive your healing in Jesus' name. You are delivered in Jesus' name. Hold on to that miracle right now. It is done. Confirm it in every life, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen, you got it. I said amen, you got it. Amen, it has happened. Check up yourself. The miracle is right there.